Hello, and welcome back. Part 26. Here we go. Alright, so no camera issue this time, hopefully. Alright, this one goes down, the other one goes up. Right. I'm just trying to make sure I have everything. Enemies no longer attack during 0G. There's one thing that's bothering me. Elizabeth has been here longer. And I don't know why the marker hasn't fully messed with her yet. Like how it's messing with Isaac at the moment. Something.
Exiting vacuum.
Master. Ah, I'm so used to games doing that thing. I'm missing two things from Hydra. Missing two things from chapter 4. Just this. I don't know. I hope I got it. Shoot. I wanted to check something, but I'll do it on the next store thing. I kind of want to use one of the DLC skins now. Thank you. So every time I pass a vent, they try to add a scary noise to it, which is different from the original, so... Comes access hall. I can do USG now. Okay, I can comms control room. License operator somehow. Comms access storage.
Clearance confirmed.
No transmission equipment. Caution. Unshielded room. No transportation. Oh, no transmission equipment. Control. Maximum of 4 passengers. Rapid transit. Rapid transit, maximum of 4 passengers. Maintenance gondola.
Dishes together and blew up the system.
So we're screwed.
No, it was sloppy work. Some of the dishes are intact. If I replace them and create a new circuit with no gaps, we could broadcast a signal. Short range only, but it should work.
Okay, do it. I'll keep an eye on things here.
Dishes maligned. Correct dish alignment to reactor the comms are. Secrets in here. I don't know if I read that one. I need to fix up the comms array so we can contact the rescue ship, the USM Valor. But what's a military ship doing way out here? East Bailey, first CO.
Log, first comms operator Bailey reporting. I want this on record. The ship is under attack, but Captain Matthias has refused to issue a distress call. And we all know why. This whole operation is illegal. Aegis 7 was sealed off. They knew it, and we all kept our mouths shut. That ends now. Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is USG Ishimura calling C. Wait. He took the whole comms array offline. It's over.
Bailey's. Just need one more, right? Supervisor Benson with the hanger.
Report, Captain Benjamin Mathias to Paragon Jordan, Una. This will be my last transmission. Afterwards, I'll make sure our pilgrimage can be completed without interference. We have successfully brought the Holy Marker on board. Dr. Kine, an expert on the original marker, is deciphering its secrets. Forgive me for quarantining you just 7. Director Eckhart's work may have been inconvenienced, but suffering some sort of epidemic. Regardless, planet crack begins tomorrow on schedule. CEC can scratch out its illegal operation now that the true prize is ours. Let's see Earth go try to cover this up. Altman be praised. Mathias out.
Wait, hold on, let me see the salute.
Sent message retrieved from array buffer.
Progress report, Captain Benjamin Mathias to Paragon Jordan, Una. This will be my last transmission. Afterwards, I'll make sure our pilgrimage can be completed without interference. We have successfully brought the Holy Marker on board. Dr. Kine, an expert on the original marker, is deciphering its secrets. Forgive me for quarantining you just 7. Director Eckhart's work may have been inconvenienced, but you're suffering some sort of epidemic. Regardless, planet crack begins tomorrow on schedule. CEC can scratch out its illegal operation now that the true prize is ours. Let's see Earth go try to cover this up. Altman be praised. With eyes out.
Because I thought in part 2, it's where the tips of your fingers try to touch each other and it's supposed to look like the marker. Like he's kind of doing it, but the tips aren't trying to look at each other. Like the back hands aren't bending towards the tips. It looks more like a V than a marker to me. Whatever, I'm not gonna care. Comms array locker room. Equipment is strictly prohibited. Reminder. Unlicensed. Broadcast. CEC equipment room. Equipment is strictly prohibited. Okay. Thank you.
transmits message retrieved from array buffer.
Progress report.
Isn't this place longer? At least they improved the lighting in this area. Pretty sure I'm doing this wrong.
Thank you.
What am I not doing right? These two are connected. Pretty sure I need both.
To the Valor.
I go to the comms there, right? Thank you. Surviving dishes are realigned. Once I activate the comms area, we should be able to contact the USM family.
Exiting zero gravity.
USM Valor, broadcasting on all frequencies to USG Ishimura in response to your SOS. We've picked up your escape pod number 47 and are en route to your position. This message will repeat every 30 seconds until you respond.
Escape pod?
Oh, fuck! The pod Hammond jettisoned. It had Chip. That creature was inside.
No. USM Valor, come in! Come in, Valor! Oh, her signal isn't strong enough.
Can we deploy the long-range antenna?
No, something's blocking the blast doors over the comms array. The hell?
There'll be a manual release over at maintenance. I'll go. Keep trying to reach them.
Deploy the antenna. Can't transmit to the USM Valor without the long-range antenna, and something is blocking the blast doors above it. They have Hammond's escape pod. I need to hurry. Comms relay crew, Prison Log, E. Bailey, first comms officer, our visitor. It happened again. Third time in the last however long it's been. I came in after shift and found Russo at the transmitter again. They looked like hell. I don't know if they'd even slept since the last time I caught them in here. Not very reassuring to see the chief engineer in that state. Russo didn't hear me come in. So this time I just listened. They were talking to the relay crew again. Talking, then listening. They even laughed. God, how long it's been since anyone on this fucking ship laughed. I know I should say something to engineering. I've already told Russo over and over that we don't have a comms relay crew. That the array is broken beyond repair. That no one is coming to save us. And they listen, but it's like, they can't get those thoughts in their head. As if it's too much. I get it. Everything on the ship is too much. So this time, I just let them talk. If a broken transmitter and a mic full of static gives them something to hold on to, maybe it helps them keep this ship running a little longer. Who am I to judge? And yeah, maybe I've talked into the same transmitter myself once or twice after hours. just in case. Like that poem says, hope sings the tune without the words and never stops at all.